to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Russian tea. Now this is a drink that we had in my family when I was growing up. So this is an old recipe. We always had it around Christmas time and we didn't have it the rest of the year. But it's a spiced tea and that's probably the reason that we had it around Christmas time. Since it's a hot tea, it's really good for those cold winter nights, which are what we're having in Kentucky right now. So I'm sure that Rick and I will enjoy this tonight, and you'll see it soon, and you can make some for yourself if you like the idea. You need some freshly made tea. It doesn't really have to be fresh, but you need tea. What you need is 1 quart. Depends on how much you want to make. You can always double this if you want to have a lot, or you can take half of it if you want to have less. Now, if you need any help making tea, I do have a video on making iced tea. If you have any trouble looking that up in Betty's Kitchen, then you can do a search for pattern glass, because I gave a tour of my pattern glass that day, and then I ended up choosing a pitcher to make iced tea in. So we have our 1 quart of iced tea, and that's the same as 4 cups. Now, moving on, we're going to use some fruit here. I need 1 1/2 oranges. So what I'm going to do is actually squeeze the juice from this, and I'll put the juice in here, and then I'll put the orange peeling, orange rind, in here. Now here we have 1 lemon. I'll be doing the same for the lemon. So I'm going to go away and get this prepared because it takes so much time. I'll squeeze the lemon, put the juice in with the orange juice, and put the rind of the lemon in this pot. So I'll come back when that's accomplished and we'll continue with our Russian tea. Here are the rinds that I have of the oranges and lemons. It was just 1 1/2 orange and 1 whole lemon. So you put the leftover rinds in a pot that's fairly large. This is 2 quart pot. And then here is the juice that I got. This is lemon juice and orange juice. Don't worry about the amount that you have. It may vary depending on how juicy the oranges and lemons that you have are. And if you compare it to mine, you might say, well, I had twice as much or I had half as much. It doesn't really matter because the remainder of the juice is in here and it's still going to be used in some fashion in this drink. But I'm going to set this saved juice aside. And what I'm going to do is combine some sugar. We'll need 1 cup of sugar with these rinds. And then I'm going to put some water in. You need 2 cups of water. And then our spices go in. The spices you need will be 6 cloves, whole cloves. Just put those in there. And you need 1 stick of cinnamon. So here is our mixture that we're going to take to the stove, and we will bring this to a boil and we'll boil it for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, I will strain it and come back and we'll continue with our Russian tea. I've boiled the rinds with the spices and sugar and water for 5 minutes. And you can see this is what was left after I used a colander to drain it. And I put what I got over here. If you want it further strained, you can use a strainer, or at this point you can use a tea strainer if you wanted to, but there might be a little pulp. I don't find that bad. I think it's kind of good to have a little bit in there, so it's just up to you if you want it strained more. But this can go in with our tea, and I think I'll try to end up with all of it over here, so I'm just going to pour this gently in. This is very hot. It just came from the stove. The tea is sort of room temperature because I just made it freshly right before I started this video. So we have the juice that has the rind flavor and the spices and the sugar in. And then we have our reserved juice. This would be the orange juice and the lemon juice. So we're going to put that in. Now what you do at this point, let's turn it around. You cover it and just put it in the refrigerator. I think I do see a few seeds. You can pick those out. But cover it with plastic wrap, put it in the refrigerator. Then whenever you want some tea, you can heat as much or as little as you want. You can put it all back in here and heat all of it if you have several people to serve tea to, or you can just get an individual serving like this. So I'm going to dip out. Since this is warm enough for me right now, I'm not going to take it back to the stove, but I'll use a ladle to show you what it would look like in this Christmas cup. And I'm avoiding any of the seeds, but you can take care of the seeds before you serve it to somebody. Here's what it looks like. It's nice and full-bodied. It's full of spices, but it's tangy and it's sweet as well. I'm gonna take a little sip. I have it in the wrong hand for me. It's just loaded with flavor. Now, you know I love iced tea, and I drink hot tea occasionally. I like that too, but this is just super good because of the extra flavors of the fruits and also the spices. I think you'll love it.